Hey there, Rebus Forever here. I said I'd make another 1-minute-ish review when the last one got to 150. Same rules apply this time around, except I won't be sharing this one on Reddit. So at 150 views, I will start making another. And you know, sharing is caring. And when I say that, I'm not trying to extort your support via PayPal and Patreon. I mean that sharing my content online helps me a lot, while also attempting to extort your support via PayPal and Patreon. Anyway, here goes. The rebels were to the east, foul monsters to the south and west, and a hostile empire was expanding on my north. My only option was clear.
War!
Okay, this footage might not be entirely representative, perhaps a touch dishonest. Let's begin again. The rebels were to the east, foul monsters to the south and west, with a hostile empire expanding on my northern flank. My only option was war! This is definitely a serious game for serious grown-ups. Circle Empires is a pretty cheapo game, RTS by nature, with a dark brooding aesthetic that makes Christian Bale's Batman voice seem by contrast mirthful, like that of a friendly clown, you might say. Circle Empires is a fairly fast-paced wee little strategy game, which for some reason is sadly and confusingly bereft of multiplayer. What it does got is free modes, all of which can be played in a range of difficulties and sizes to suit all tastes, allowing for an experience ranging from quick and casual to massive and infuriatingly hard. Loads of leaders to unlock who all bring their own faction bonus or unit selections, and enough cutesy graphics to seriously undermine even the most hardcore gamer's street cred. Circle Empires could use some refinements and screams out for multiplayer, but for this price, a grindy single-player experience with a bunch of stuff to unlock is still worth the cost. A game of Circle Empires generally descends into a fast-paced spamming event, with various factions' worker units providing the economic backbone for your militaristic aims. A limited selection of buildings provide you with the means to generate gold, expand your roster of beasties, or else defend your territory. The majority of your time will be spent managing your troops, reacting to enemy invasions, raiding neighboring territories, and committing to outright war. The graphics, cutesy though they may be, are clear at a glance and make playing the larger maps and reacting to the enemy attacks a lot easier than perhaps a more realistic game might have been able. The devs still seem to be supporting the game with patches and running a competition a few months back, which is maybe a good sign for future features. But for a 4 a.m. impulse buy, thanks to an email from Steam, I've sunk 8 hours into this totally credible and grown-up game for grown-ups. If you like yourself some stripped-down offline fast-paced RTS-ness, you could go a lot more wrong than owning this game. Thanks for watching, like, subscribe, tell me why I'm wrong in the comments, or support my channel via PayPal or Patreon. If you would have preferred this to be a more AAA title, Steam groups and all of that jazz on the front page, and toodle pip.